Hey, what's up, guys? It's Grant here. Listen, if you've been wanting to get yourself an iPhone 10, we have one and we're giving it away to one of you. So make sure your name is on the list. We got a link down in the description for a contest. There's only one more week to get registered. So get your name on the list, iPhone 10 giveaway. See you in April.
Hey guys, I'm Nate. Welcome back to the workshop. Today we're gonna be doing some fun experiments with fire, and specifically we're gonna see if we can create a nice rainbow effect using different types of chemicals mixed in with our flames. We've got a couple different sources of fuel and a whole lot of different chemicals that we can try mixing into our flames. Let's see which ones give us the best result. We have two different versions of this heat product, which are designed to help clean your engine. We've got some 91% isopropyl alcohol and some 70% isopropyl alcohol. And we'll see what color each of these burns on its own and what we want to try and use as our fuel source. These little pieces of aluminum were just some tea light candles that I popped the candle out of. Let's see what color each of these burn. Well, we have a very bright yellowish orange color. We have a slightly more subdued yellowish orange color, a very pale yellow orange color, and one that in this amount of light you can barely see, but it mostly looks blue. It's almost invisible. Let's try turning off the lights and see how things look. Our blue flame is a little bit more visible. It's still pretty clear. There's not a lot showing up in there, but it's not bad. I think that the yellow heat gave us the best result for something that we'll be able to use to change the color because it had very little bright color of its own. So let's run our chemical experiments using this. Let's try going in order. The first color we want to try and get is a nice red. I've heard that the best thing for that is to get some lithium out of a lithium battery and then dissolve that in this liquid. The lithium in our battery should create a compound which will burn with a very bright red, almost magenta color. Ooh, certainly reacts quickly. All right, that seems mostly reacted. Let's see what happens if we ignite this. Will we get a red flame like we are theoretically supposed to? Whoa! Yeah, we do. It's pretty good red right there. Like, that is a red, almost magenta colored flame. I am liking that. Cool. We've got red. Let's put that out, set that aside, and let's see if we can get an orange. Now for orange, my research has said that calcium chloride can give you a good orange colored flame. And an easy source of calcium chloride is some types of sidewalk salt that's meant for melting ice and snow. And the stuff that I got is shaped into these little prills, these small little beads. I'm not sure if it being in the bead form is better or the powdered form is better, so we'll try grinding it up into a powder and then we'll see if that gives us a better or worse effect than the little beads. All right, we'll do a side-by-side comparison. We'll add a little bit more of the methanol to the prills and then we'll also add some into the powder. That turned orange much faster, although this is a pretty good orange color as well.
I don't know, I think we're kind of getting more off of the powder. I think either one works, really. You just need enough of the fuel to kind of cover the prills or the powder, and then you get a good orange color.
My research says that the best way to get a yellow flame is by burning something with sodium in it. Baking soda, or sodium bicarbonate, or sodium chloride, table salt. We're gonna try both of these in the methanol, and we're gonna compare that to the bright yellow we were getting as we burned the red heat. We'll see which one gives us the best yellow color. Here goes, looking for yellow flame. The red heat immediately gives us yellow flame. Our table salt, or I guess this is sea salt, but it's the same stuff, just in a slightly different shape. That's a kind of a yellow flame, a little bit more orange than this. Our baking soda is taking longer to get going, but we're now starting to get a visible flame on that. Again, that's kind of orange. In my opinion, there's a pretty clear winner here. The two different versions of the sodium are giving us a yellowish flame, and that's pretty good. And in fact, I actually kind of like the color of the baking soda the best, but there's just so much good yellow coming off of the red heat fuel that I think we might have to go with that one. Moving on to green, every resource I could find recommended the same thing, boric acid, which is usually found as an ant and roach killing powder. Let's just try putting that in, adding some methanol, and see what color it burns. Ooh, That is immediately green. Like no warm-up time with a blue flame or an orange flame. That went straight to green. No wonder everyone recommends this stuff. It's pretty conclusive. That's green. It looks like something straight out of Harry Potter. Next up is blue, and as we saw, the methanol by itself actually burns a fairly blue color, but it's not very intense, so I'm wondering if there's anything we can add to try and get that blue to show up a little bit more. Something online suggested that we can use the copper sulfate crystals in this root kill, and that that could bring out some of the color, so we're gonna try that. Saw a little flash of green as I lit the one with powder in it. Pretty much the same effect as the crystallized form. It looks mostly blue with little bits of green here and there in it. Might have a little bit less yellow streaking, which is something we're also seeing in our crystallized one. All right, that's almost a turquoise color. So we'll keep that in mind. The last color that we want to make is violet, and from what I've seen, the best way to get that color is from burning potassium chloride. Potassium chloride is most easily found in sodium-free salt substitute. Now, although this does contain potassium chloride, it does have some other chemicals in it as well, so it may not be a very pure source. That is already a pretty fine powder, so I really don't know how much this is gonna change. Only one way to know. Ooh, that was a nice little burst of purple at first. It's like purple mixed with orange, which isn't really a color I think about mixing much, but kind of what it looks like. But I think there's more purple visible in it as well. Maybe not so much purple as lavender. Orange up top, lavender down at the bottom maybe? This little contraption that Nighthawk and Light came up with it's just a waste basket set on top of like a Lazy Susan spinner. I actually glued it in place just so that the wastebasket wouldn't slide off if some of the weight got shifted. It was a really good result. So now I want to see if we can combine three different colors and get a multi-colored sort of flame going through the air. So I'm going to try the red and the green because those are both really vibrant. And then I think I'll try using some of the alcohol as a yellow fuel and see if we can get red, green, and yellow all burning together. Give it a spin. That's one heck of a thing. All right, let's put this out. We've made a multicolored fire vortex. We've made several different colors. Let's line all of the different variations up and see if we can get that whole rainbow look that we're looking for. Just a couple of seconds to start warming up to their colors. I'm already liking what I'm seeing. We have lithium dissolved in the methyl alcohol. We then have our calcium chloride. For the yellow color, I'm going with the red heat. For the green, of course, we have the boric acid. We've got the copper sulfate ground up into a powder as sort of an in-between the green and the blue. For the blue alone, we're going for the methanol by itself with nothing else in it. And for the purple, we're trying the ground up non-sodium salt. That's a good rainbow if you ask me. It takes some refueling to get everything to stay nice and lit and show the colors really well, but I love how it looks. Hey guys, quick reminder, there's a link down in the description right now where you could win this 256 gig iPhone 10 or all expenses paid round trip tickets to come join Chris and I at our self-made YouTube training in April. Or you could just click right down there. Hit the bomb if you're not already a subscriber and we'll see you at self-made.